Hello YouTube, Jackson here. Today I'm gonna give you 5 adjustments that you can make to your fixed gear bike that will make it easier to do tricks, better for doing tricks, and guess what? They're all free. So let's get into it. If you're new to this channel, welcome, thank you for joining me. Make sure you smash that subscribe button, hit that notification bell, smack the links in the description, because I got a ton of other videos and tutorials for doing tricks on your fixed gear bikes, edits, all kinds of stuff. Join me, join the FOD gang. Without any further ado, let's get into the list. The first and easiest thing that you can do to make sure you're ready to roll and do some tricks is making sure you got proper PSI. This is not groundbreaking, it's a pretty obvious adjustment. If you're doing any sort of aerial tricks like bunny hops, 180s, I have tutorials on those, check out the links in the description. You're gonna wanna make sure that you have high PSI so that you don't pinch flat. Fixed gears, we like our really skinny tires, and if you're running 23C, 25C, even 28C, you run the risk of pinch flatting. It's really easy to do. It's such a bummer when it happens, and pumping up your tires, especially your rear tire, because there's more weight there, will definitely help reduce the amount of pinch flats that you get. There is a limit to this. You don't want to pump up your tires past the manufacturer recommendation. You run the risk of them blowing out. They're also going to be really, really hard, so all of the energy is going to be transferred through your bike. If you are doing tricks, I would recommend, if you can, run bigger tires, but that's not really a part of this video because you'd have to spend money. Having high PSI will also help if you're doing any sort of skid tricks. It'll give you less friction when you're doing the skid. Another reason for a high proper PSI is that you're gonna be doing a lot of quick turning movements when you're doing tricks. And if your PSI is too low, the tire can sort of deflect off the bead of the rim and it'll just feel really weird and wonky and bad. So that tip was pretty much a given, but this one is a little less obvious and does require tools, but will make your bike feel a lot more nimble and playful. And that tip is shortening your chain if you can. Take a look at your dropouts. If your wheel is at the very end of your dropouts, you might have some room to take out a link and bring your wheel further forward in the dropouts. Basically what that does is makes your wheelbase shorter. That's gonna make the bike feel a lot better for popping it up, doing rotations. It's just gonna make everything feel a lot more nimble, a lot more playful. I always try to run my chain as short as I can. Depending on what bike you have and how long your chain is right now, you may or may not be able to do this. If you've got really short dropouts or you're already in the middle of your dropouts, if you take out a link, it might be too short so you won't even be able to get your wheel in there. Now this is a little bit beyond the scope of this video, but you could consider getting a chain with a half link. BMXers run half link chains for this reason. They can make micro adjustments in their chain line. Odyssey Bluebird is a great one. I run it on a lot of my bikes. That being said, I don't really like chains that are full half links. They tend to stretch, they're not as strong. And so I usually get regular chains with one little half link in there. That way you can just make that nice little micro adjustment. Chains cost money, so a little extra tip for you. And for the next tip on the subject of chains is making sure that your chain is nice and tight. Doing tricks on fixed gears is all about pedal pressure, either forwards or backwards. And if your chain is really loose, you're not gonna be able to get the proper pedal pressure. It's gonna give a little bit before you actually are putting pressure into the back wheel. It just feels bad and awful. It's pretty obvious to tell if your chain is too loose. You don't want any sort of slack in it for doing tricks. You want it to be taut with some tension, but obviously not over-tensioned. If you tighten the chain too much, you're gonna run the risk of breaking your chain. It's also gonna have a lot more friction in your drivetrain, which doesn't feel good either. It's something that you kinda just have to get a feel for. I usually push my wheel back, tighten it down all the way, and make sure that I can still move my chain with my fingers pretty easily. I'll also spin the wheel, make sure there's not too much friction and that it's not stopping too quickly. Another little bonus tip, I didn't have this on the list originally, but make sure that your wheels are nice and tight, especially your rear wheel. If you're doing tricks, you know, you're landing, you might have the wheel shift sideways. That chain tension that you just worked so hard to get perfect could shift around, your wheel could shift forward. Make sure you tighten those wheels down high and tight. Hello, me again with another bonus tip. My favorite way to adjust my rear wheel is by flipping the bike over and straddling the bike. It really helps me adjust it from side to side. It's easy to push it back so that I can get the proper chain tension. You can scuff up your handlebars, but it's not something I really worry about when doing tricks. Next tip on the list is checking your foot retention. I personally like BMX platform pedals and straps. I think they offer a good solution that you could put a lot of force into, but you can also get out of relatively easily. When I'm adjusting my foot retention, I want them to be pretty snug. I like having my feet pretty deep into the straps above where like the ball of my foot is. And so I want them pretty snug, but I also want to be able to get out of the straps relatively easily.
When I'm setting the tightness of my straps, I like to have about a half inch of movement.
This is something that you can practice. Make sure that you have that really fast response time to get your feet out of the straps so that you can put your foot down, because tricks, you know, you're gonna fall doing tricks. It sucks when you're not able to get your feet out of the straps. It happens to me all the time, even still, but it's something that you can practice and make sure your bike is properly set up to do. Having a nice, comfortable upright position is definitely beneficial for doing tricks. If you don't want to go out and buy a new stem or handlebars, adjusting your stack height could be a good solution. If you've got any spacers that are above your stem, you can put it below to effectively raise your bar height. Take off your top cap and look inside your steer tube, see if there's any additional room to add some spacers, move up your stem.
If you're adding an additional spacer underneath your stem, make sure that you're really, really careful with this. You want to make sure that your stem has enough steer tube to grab on. You don't want the top lip of the steer tube to be too far below your stem. You want to make sure that both bolts can tighten onto the steer tube, grab it nice and tight. You don't want to be pulling up a wheelie that first time and have your stem come flying off. You can damage yourself, you can damage your bike. If you don't know what you're doing, consult with your local bike shop. Another thing that you can do to adjust your handlebar height is flipping your stem. Some, but not all, stems have a small amount of either rise or drop. You can run it either direction. Check out your stem. If it looks like it's sloping downwards, you can actually flip it and it'll give you just a little bit extra handlebar height.
The last and definitely not least important tip is adjusting your saddle height. If you've watched any of the trick tutorials on this channel, you know that I talk about this one all the time. Fixed gears are such big, goofy bikes, and you need to be able to move around, adjust your balance, and it's just really hard to do when your saddle is all the way up at the proper riding position.
One thing to note is that a lot of people don't actually know their proper saddle height. I'll link to one of my favorite calculators down in the description. That way you can get that starting point and start making adjustments from there.
It's not totally necessary depending on the trick and what your preferences are. You know, if you wanna just keep your bike ready to commute at any time, you can definitely leave it that way and still do tricks. If you're doing aerial tricks like bunny hops, 180s, especially when you're first learning, you're gonna wanna put that seat pretty low down, as far as you can go, in fact, because you're not using the seat for anything. Tricks like wheelies, kios require that you put your body weight into your saddle, so you're gonna wanna keep it at a relatively regular, comfortable riding position. Even with those tricks, I like to move my saddle down, you know, half, quarter of an inch, just so I get a little bit of extra room to move my body around. And that is it. I hope you enjoyed these tips. If you have any tips, drop them in the comments below. I've got a whole other video about all of the things that you can do to make your bike super dialed for fixed gear trick riding. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. Follow me and Foad on Instagram and TikTok. If any of these tutorials help you, hashtag Foad tutorial on Instagram for a chance to be featured on the channel. Make sure you check out foadgang.com for gear. And that is it. I will see you in the next one. Thank you for watching.